Hello everyone. Dear colleagues, for today's virtual workshop, we had to adapt to the online condition and we decide to present the theoretical part in which we include all the existing international protocols and classifications so far related to the thyroid ultrasonography linked to the presentation of our cross-border project called Thyro-screen, which is currently underway. The Thyro-screen project is a target thyroid ultrasound screening initially preceded by the launch of the online electronic questionnaires addressed to the population at high risk for thyroid cancer for inclusion in the project based on the international validated risk criteria, followed by an ultrasound investigator family physician representing the first level of the screening. We specify that it is a multidisciplinary screening on the several levels, primary, secondary, and tertiary, in which several endocrinologists and oncology surgeons who are part of the medical team in this international project participate. It is very important that in this project we use diagnostic algorithms to stratify the oncological risk based on the artificial intelligence as a means of the supporting ultrasonography tool provided by the accredited family doctors. The gold standard method of this study is represented in the project by the cytological and histopathological exam by which we want to validate this diagnostic method. We also included in the workshop numerous image and practical demonstration movies related to the thyroid pathology. We will send to the chat during the workshop presentation the access to the link to the Smart Thyroid software to try to access all the participants on your personal computers during the scrolling of the image and to calculate the four risk scores in the Smart software and the diagnosis algorithms. We are presenting the thyroid ultrasonography in the current practice of the family doctors. Early diagnosis of the thyroid malignancy in the family doctor's office. What is screening? As a definition, it is an assessment of the population at risk for a certain type of cancer to diagnose the disease at early stage when no symptoms are present. We have some types of screening, the general population screening addressed to the general population regardless of the presence of risk factors, and the targeted screening addressed only to the certain group of the population who present risk factors for a certain disease. What is the purpose of the thyroid ultrasound screening? Did you know that about 38 to 40% of the high-risk population has thyroid diseases? The thyroid cancer can be present in up to 3% of the high-risk population. When the diagnosis is in the early stage, the thyroid cancer is curable in almost 98% of the cases. The late diagnosis could reduce 5-year survival to 37%. In the recent decades in Europe, after the nuclear accident of Chernobyl, we observe a clear increase over 10 times of the thyroid diseases, predominantly because of the multinodular goiter and autoimmune thyroiditis. The prevalence of the malignant thyroid nodules are growing, mostly being 80% papillary microcarcinoma. We tried to analyze this using Doppler ultrasound and then we were made the strain elastography to identify the tumor stiffness. The Doppler ultrasound, used as a screening method, can diagnose both The diffuse thyroid disorders, such as malformation, multinodular goiter, and thyroiditis, and especially the focal lesion, as the benign and malignant tumors. Pie charts present the distribution of cases and deaths for the 10 most common cancers in 2018 for the both sex, males and females. For each sex, the area of the pie chart reflects the proportion of the total number of cases or deaths. In these pie charts, you can observe the thyroid cancer occupied the fifth place in incidence. And also in this incidence graphics, you can observe the first place are occupied for the breast cancer, the second for the cervix uterine cancer, the third of the colorectal cancer, the fourth of the lung cancer, and the fifth by the thyroid cancer. It is a high incidence of the thyroid cancer. And the most common cancer types for the age between 20 to 49 in the woman, who was the first place occupied by the breast cancer, the second by the thyroid cancer, and the third for the melanoma cancer. It is a high incidence to this age for the woman. This project has three main stages. The first step was the development of the computerized diagnostic algorithm entitled Smart Thyroid Ultrasound Software, use it to stratify the risk in the thyroid pathology based on the conventional ultrasound and Doppler and elastography. It set the optimum time for the thyroid puncture, the fine needle aspiration cytology, and the cytological exam for early diagnosis of the malignant lesions. We have used the latest international classification as well as a scoring made by us correlated with the cytological or histopathological results as a gold standard method. The second stage includes a targeted thyroid screening monocentric in a population with high risk conducted in a single medical clinic, statistically significant on the 5,000 persons. At the third stage, we are launching an interdisciplinary multicentric ultrasound screening entitled Thyro-screen. We have some questions. Why, how, and whom to do the thyroid ultrasound screening program? The Thyro-screen cross-border project, Romanian-Serbian study design. In the first stage, the risk factors are evaluated in the general population by filling a questionnaire by the family doctors or directly by the patients online. The patients who have risk factors for thyroid pathology and who have inclusion criteria will be evaluated clinical and ultrasonographical by 20 Sentinel family physicians accredited in ultrasonography and thyroid. All the data obtained from the ultrasonographic control will be entered into an intelligent diagnostic algorithm, and the patient identified positively on screening for thyroid pathology are re-evaluated paraclinical and ultrasonographical by the endocrinologist. Patients who fall into a high-risk class Thyros 4 or 5 will be evaluated by fine needle aspiration cytology under the ultrasound guidance. If the patient raised the suspicion of malignant pathology, a Bethesda cytological exam will be treated by the oncologist surgeon. All physicians enter in all the data in the smart ultrasound software, which finally validates or not all the steps completed. And in the final, we have a feedback with the validation or not of the method of screening of multiparametrical ultrasonographical screening. What is the main purpose of the thyroid screening? First, the early diagnosis of thyroid cancer. The second, the early diagnosis of diffuse and focal thyroid lesions. And the transversal section of the thyroid with the high vascularity in the Doppler duplex and the nodule with high vascularity into and peripheral and also the hard stiffness of the node in the elastography. The Thyro-screen project is a targeted screening to the high risk population. After the American College of Radiology, the indication for thyroid ultrasounds are the palpable thyroid nodule or macronodular goiter, the high risk patient with a history of familial thyroid cancer, and the presence of adenopathy suggestive for the malignancy. This is the strong recommendation. The establishing of the thyroid risk classes, it is based on the family antecedents or history, the personal history of the patient, and the clinical examination. We had an epidemiological questionnaire and an online questionnaire. And who sets the risk classes? The patient self-assessment online on the questionnaire or the family doctors. And if the patient contain risk group inclusion criteria with one major factor or four minor factors, if they are present. We have an online questionnaire for the patients. This is the example for the questionnaire for the patient included in ThyroScreen with the historical questions, with the history of the thyroid cancer, the exposure to the ionizing radiation, exposure to the chemical biological risk factors, the prior hemithyroidectomy with the discovery of the thyroid cancer, the presence of diabetes or other immune autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and vitiligo, the deficiency of the excess dietary iodine, the persistence of dysphonia, dysphagia, or dyspnea without stated cause, the hoarseness due to vocal cord paralysis, and the sensitivity prolonged throat of sore throat. The symptoms suggested for the hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism, and the pregnant woman who have given birth in the last 6 months. The clinical examination include the diffuse or localized swelling on the anterocervical region, the firm, irregular and fixed thyroid nodule, the tumor invasion into adjacent structures, the rapid growth, evidence of the nodule growth, either sonographical or palpation increase more than 20% of the nodule volume in few months in the 3 or 6 months. The prolonged presence of the abnormal lymph nodes, the cervical or other neck region. As I said, the inclusion criteria depends on the existence of the oncological risk factor with the family history of malignancy, of the exposure to the chemical or the ionizing radiation, the presence of diabetes or other autoimmune disease, diffuse or localized swelling of the neck, obesity, disorders of the skin, hair and nails, tiredness and weight loss unjustified, the persistent unjustified of the esophthalmia, dysphonia, dysphagia, or dyspnea, and the pregnant woman. The exclusion criteria include the chronic carriers of the virus bacteria, the chronic organ failure, the oncological disorders, the collagen disease, and unbalanced metabolic diseases, the intake of the corticosteroids and immunosuppressant treatment or chemotherapy or regarding to the clinical parameters, we have three questions. What factors from the patient history are important for screening? What clinical parameters will we consider for the selection of the high-risk population of thyroid pathology, and who are the inclusion and exclusion criteria for the thyroid? The physical exam of the thyroid patients include the inspection of the neck, the palpation of the paratracheal area, the palpation of lateral neck, the pulse rate, and the looking for the ectophthalmia or hoarseness of voice of distal. We must find the symptoms and the physical signs of the hyperthyroidism, like the heat intolerance, the hyperdefecation, the emotional lability, the poor concentration, nervousness, weakness, fatigability, the tachycardia, atrial fibrillation, smooth skin and warm palms, tremor, onycholysis, the lymphadenopathy, and the proximal muscular weakness. And also, we must find the symptoms of physical sign of the hypothyroidism, like cold intolerance, the constipation, the lethargy, arthralgia, dry skin, delayed relaxation muscles, dry skin, myxedema skin, and hoarseness and mental clonic. In addition to assessing thyroid function by determining hormones like TSH, thyrostimulin hormone, thyroxine, the triiodothyronin, they determine the presence of the hypo, hyper, or normal status, should be determined the antibodies described in the autoimmune thyroid disease, like the thyroglobulin antibodies and the thyroperoxidase antibodies, who are specific to the Hashimoto thyroiditis, and also to determine the presence of the TSH receptor antibodies, who are characteristic for the Graves disease. The ultrasound thyroid evaluation identified the gland with two lobes and one isthmus. The thyroid volume measurements, the evaluation of the echogenicity and echostructure, the parenchyma vascularization degree, the presence of the nodules with characterization of the nodule, vascularization and hardness, and regional adenopathy. This screening is important because 4 out of every 10 Romanians have a thyroid disorders. The indication for thyroid ultrasonography following by the American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists are to confirm the presence of the thyroid nodule, to characterize a thyroid nodule, to differentiate between benign and malign thyroid masses, to differentiate between thyroid nodules and other cervical masses, to evaluate diffuse changes in the thyroid parenchyma, to detect the postoperative residual or recurrent tumor in the thyroid bed, to screen high-risk patients for the thyroid malignancy, and to guide diagnostic for the fine needle aspiration cytology or therapeutic intervention procedures. To the grayscale in B mode, we take some measurements, and the normal thyroid dimension depends of the age, of the gender, and of the populational type. And to the newborns, the longitudinal diameters are between 10 to 10, 20 millimeters, and the anterior-posterior is between 8 to 9 millimeters. To the adults, the longitudinal diameter or craniocaudal diameter are between 4 and 6 centimeters, and the anterior-posterior diameter is between 13 and 18 millimeters. The thyroid ultrasound screening was performed on 4,386 apparently healthy adults with oncological risk factor, age over 20 years, followed for 3 years with the sex ratio 2 to 1. To the patient age between 20 to 40 years, we have conducted an ultrasound screening every 2 years and over 40 years annually. The objective was the diagnosis and early treatment of the both the diffuse and focal thyroid lesion by ultrasound screening to high-risk patients. The research question was, how can we improve the early diagnosis and differentiation of the thyroid diseases by family physician? The aim was to assess the applicability of both Doppler and strain elastography in the differentiation benign versus malign tumors, as well as in the differentiation of the various types of thyroiditis, and to design a diagnosis scoring system and the computerized algorithm for performing thyroid ultrasound. We use the multiparametric thyroid ultrasound to the high-risk population with the power and Doppler, duplex and triplex ultrasound of the thyroid as a screening ultrasound was the best diagnostic tools in the initial assessment of thyroid pathology We use the Thyros classification by RAS and all for standardization accuracy of reporting, for easy communication among practitioners, and to indicate when the fine needle aspiration biopsy should be performed. The strain elastography based on the principle of abnormal tissue affected by fibrosis, inflammatory infiltration or malignant process tend to be stiffer than healthy tissue. It has stiffness. We use the qualitative classification of color code image of the thyroid tumor obtained by strain elastography proposed by Rego and all in 5 types of elasticity, and also we use the strain ratio as a semi-quantitative marker of stiffness. Our cutoff value of the strain ratio for malignant tumor was over 2.5. The malignant ultrasound score is assessing of the thyroid tumors. And it is a score with features obtained of the pathological parameters in the ultrasound. And the gold method was histopathology in the fine needle aspiration cytology. On the transversal section, the hypervascularity of the parenchymal lobe and also the measurements of the inferior thyroid artery. The high vascularity in the power Doppler of the parenchyma and the measurements of the inferior thyroid artery. The measurements of the superior thyroid artery and the measurements of the inferior thyroid artery in the pulse Doppler, and also the superior artery. The hypervascularization of the parenchyma in the section and transversal section in the duplex and power Doppler, and also the hypervascularity of the thyroid in the Graves' disease, and hypervascularity in longitudinal section in the right and left lobes, and the hypervascularization of the lobes in the Graves' disease. And so the hypervascularity lobe in the longitudinal section, and in the elastography you can observe the heart stiffness of the entire lobe, and the hypervascularization in the Hashimoto thyroiditis, and the presence of the nodule which is well delimited, but with the extracapsular extension in the transversal section, nodule is isoechogenic and homogeneous, with the peripheral vascularization in the power Doppler and in duplex Doppler, and the left lobe with the hypervascularization of the parenchyma in the power Doppler, and the peripheral vascularization of the node with the heart stiffness in the Rego 4 scores. And with the heart stiffness, its entire nodule is in blue color code, and also the presence of the strain ratio over 2.5, and was a micropapillary carcinoma. And the dimension, the craniocaudal dimension in the longitudinal scan, and also the peripheral vascularization, and also the measurements of the strain ratio in the longitudinal scan. A correct ultrasound examination depends of the examiner's eyes, depends of the ultrasound machine you use, and depends of the patient preparation in hyperextension with the neck. The ultrasound probe contains the piezoelectric crystals that emit ultrasounds into tissue, and when they encounter a high density structure or an interface, reflecting waves occur that return back to the quartz crystals that turn them into an electrical signal that will form the final image on the monitor. In the thyroid ultrasound, we use high frequency with a high resolution and short depth penetration between 7.5 to 15 MHz frequency. You may describe the organ size, the organ shape, the contour, the position, the echogenicity, the echo structure, the landmark like trachea, muscle, like sternocleidomastoidian, the common carotid artery and the jugular vein, the vasculature, the stiffness, and the presence of diffuse or focal pathological lesion. The good quality of the ultrasound image requires the ultrasound waves to be perpendicular to the tissue separation surface. The loss of ultrasonic energy from the surface to the depth is called the attenuation phenomena. The examination technique, the patient lies down in the supine position with the neck in hyperextended. We use a linear probe with high frequency and use tissue Doppler and elastography. The examination of the thyroid is performed step by step and is done in cross section of the upper area of the chin and slowly descends with a slight sweep to the suprasternal lesion, examine both lobes, then it turns each lobe, then move to the longitudinal section on both lobes. The patient is lying down. We use the longitudinal and the transverse plan, and you must know the orientation of the body related to the desktop, to the monitor. The impedance is the tissue resistance to propagation of ultrasound. It depends on density of biological tissue or crossed environment. The echogenicity, we can have the reflectogenic structures in the solid object with hyperechoic, hypoechoic, or isoechoic, or anechoic or transonic structures like fluids, like blood, secretion, acid, and cyst, or mixed structure, the combination of the first two. The echo structure can be homogeneous or unhomogeneous, micronodular and micronodular. The role of the thyroid ultrasound may be resumed in three main issues: to detect thyroid and cervical masses, to differentiate between possible benign and probably malign masses, and to guide the performance on finding the aspiration biopsy. The thyroid ultrasound is able to provide answers to several clinical questions. Is the palpable mass within or adjacent to the thyroid? Is the tumor confined or to the thyroid or locally invades nearby structures? Are cervical lymph nodes involved? Is there a primary focus in the thyroid gland? Is there a postoperative residual or recurrent tumor? On the transversal section, you can observe some anatomical structure from anterior to posterior, like thick skin, platysma muscle, the fascia cervicalis, the sternohyoid muscle, the sternothyroid muscle, the sternocleidomastoid muscle in the lateral, the isthmus, trachea, the right and the left thyroid lobes, the jugular vein, the carotid artery in the lateral, the esophagus in the left, and the longus coli muscles. The same structure are evidenced in the longitudinal scan, and you can make some measurements to the transversal section. You can measure the anterior-posterior diameters, the transversal diameters, and to the longitudinal section, the craniocaudal diameters of the thyroid lobe. The measurements of the anterior-posterior and transversal and craniocaudal diameters. The thyroid pathology is classified in diffuse thyroid disorders that can cause functional manifestation of hypo or hyperthyroidism, like in thyroiditis and acute thyroiditis, subacute thyroiditis, and chronic autoimmune thyroiditis like Hashimoto's thyroiditis, the Quervain subacute thyroiditis, or acute suppurative thyroiditis in the viral infection. The thyroid malformation congenital, or the macronodular goiter, and the Graves' disease. As the focal thyroid lesion, we mentioned the benign nodules like hyperplastic nodule, follicular adenoma, Hashimoto thyroiditis nodules, subacute thyroiditis nodule, or cyst or colloid nodule. The malign tumor are represented by papillary carcinoma 80%, follicular carcinoma 17%, the medullary carcinoma 4%, and the anaplastic thyroid cancer, the Halter cell carcinoma, and the thyroid metastasis and lymphoma are very rare. The ultrasonographic description of the diffuse thyroid disease include the thyroid volume with the height, the width, the length of the right and left thyroid lobe with a normal value between 15 to 25 milliliters, and it is increased in Hashimoto thyroiditis and Graves' disease, in the Quervain thyroiditis or in macronodular goiter, and decrease in hypothyroidism or in the Riddle thyroiditis. The echogenicity can be isoechoic, hyperechoic or brighter, or hypoechoic and or darker. Echo structure can be homogeneous, is normal, or unhomogeneous, with presence of the nodule or a focal lesion, or the presence of micro or macronodular structure. The parenchymal vascularity in Doppler triplex can be increased in Hashimoto thyroiditis in a Graves' disease, or decrease in hypothyroidism or in Riddle thyroiditis. And the normal structure. We did an intelligent algorithm software launched by us at the WONCA Copenhagen conference in 2016. The data who must be introduced in the intelligent software are the diameters, the anterior-posterior, transversal and craniocaudal diameters of the both lobes and the isthmus, and the echogenicity, the echostructure, and the vascularization of the parenchyma. The software have presets with the echostructure isoechoic, hyperechoic, or hypoechoic, like in our image, with the isoechoic thyroid and hypoechoic thyroid, darker. The echostructure can be homogeneous or unhomogeneous with the micro or macronodular or nodular structure, presence of no nodule. Then in smart software, you must describe the vascularization of the parenchyma, and also if you have a focal nodule, you must describe all the data obtained in ultrasonography in the Doppler power on elastographic image. The ultrasound features in the multinodular goiter are iso- or hyperechoic nodules with cystic degeneration, well-defined halo surrounding nodule, colloid component of the cystic elements with ring down sign, the heterogeneous background echostructure of the thyroid, the presence of calcifications nodule often contain floridysplastic central calcification or well-defined peripheral carvillian calcification. An assessment of the retrosternal extension should be carried out as part of the examination by scanning inferior to the level of manubrium. In the transversal section, the multinodular goiter with the hypervascularization and also with the hard stiffness of the both lobes. Hashimoto thyroiditis is the most common of the chronic thyroiditis and the most common cause of the hypothyroidism. In acute phase, the focal nodular thyroiditis, small hypoechoic nodules with ill-defined margins, is seen representing lymphocytic infiltration, starts in the anterior portion of the isthmus. In the chronic phase, enlarged slightly to lobular outline, the thyroid is diffuse hypoechoic with fine echogenic sept and small atrophic gland with heterogeneous echogenic. The features of the Hashimoto thyroiditis in the chronic phase with the hypervascularization and the micro and macronodular structure, non-homogeneous structure, and with the macronodules, hypoechoic nodules, and the measurements of the nodule and the measurements of the right lobe, and with the hard stiffness of the right lobe, and also the measurements, the craniocaudal diameters, the hypervascular power Doppler, the hypervascularization in the transversal section in the Doppler duplex and power Doppler, the hypervascularization, the unhomogeneous structure, the unhomogeneous structure and enlarge of the left lobe, the measurements of the isthmus, the vascularization of the parenchyma, hypervascularization of the parenchyma and duplex Doppler, the measurements of the left lobe, the hypervascularization of the left lobe in longitudinal section, the presence of hard stiffness in the parenchyma, right and left lobe, and also the hypervascularization in Hashimoto thyroiditis, in chronic Hashimoto. The Kerven subacute thyroiditis is a painful swelling in the lower neck, fever, and lethargy, typical following of the viral illness. The Kerven subacute thyroiditis with the nodule, hypoechogenic, with the mixed stiffness in the RAGO 2 classification. In the Graves' disease, the uniform enlarged and heterogeneous and hypoechoic in the ultrasound of the parenchyma, and the gland is diffusive hypoechoic and color flow imaging reveals an often spectacular thyroid inferno with marked hypervascularity. The diagnostic is put by the thyroid stimulating immunoglobulin, presence of this antibody in diagnosis for grave diseases, and the thyroid stimulating hormone receptor antibody. The grave disease and exophthalmia in the grave. The grave disease, the enlarged gland with the hypoechogenicity, with the unhomogeneous structure, with the macronodular, and the presence of hypervascularization in the grave disease, and the longitudinal section with the hypervascularization and power Doppler, and with the heart stiffness and the hypervascularization in both in the Doppler and also in the power Doppler. Hypervascularization in the transversal and then the long. In the thyroid focal lesion, you must describe the echogenicity of the nodule, the echostructure of the nodule, the shape, round or oval, more wider than taller or more taller than wide, the contour, the margins, the halo, regulate or irregular with the margin, poorly delimited and spiculate, calcification, presence of micro or macro calcification, the vascularization type 1, no flow detected within the nodule, the type 2 with the perinodular arterial flow patterns, and the type 3 with the intranodular flow pattern and multiple vascular pole and chaotic arrangement, and the presence of cervical or supraclavicular lymph nodes if it are benign or malign lymph nodes. And you must to take the three dimension, anterior-posterior diameter, the transversal diameter, and the craniocaudal diameter to establish the nodule volumes with the ellipsoid formula, 4P, 2, 3, and ABC diameters. In the literature, we are some ultrasound criteria associated with the malignancy, like echostructure, echogenicity, the irregular age, the vascularization, the vertical axial, the microcalcification, and the presence of the adenopathy. And another criteria. This transversal section is present an isoechogenic unhomogeneous nodule, poorly delimited, with the hypervascularization central in the peripheral, type 3 of vascularization, with the heart stiffness of the nodule in the 4 score of RAGO, and the strain ratio is more than 3.3, and the undefined delimitation and boundaries of this nodule, and the presence of the heart stiffness on the nodule, and the second measurements in the longitudinal. The another nodule with the hypervascularization peripheral in the power and the Doppler duplex, the presence of the nodule, the multinodular goiter, another image with the nodule with the extracapsular extension and presence of calcification. It is a hypoechogenic nodule, unhomogeneous with extracapsular extension, with the microcalcification diffuse, and hypervascularization, peripheral hypervascularization in power Doppler, the measurement of the isthmus, the vascularization, unhomogeneous nodule with the heart stiffness and presence of microcalcification, and the multinodular goiter, and the vascularization, peripheral vascularization type 2 of vascularization in the power Doppler and multinodular goiter, and also panoramic aspects of the thyroiditis, Hashimoto thyroid. The thyroids can do the personalized management and make the risk stratification with 5 categories and minimize unnecessary fine needle aspiration biopsy in the thyroid 2, 3, or 4A. Regardless what model you use to the stratification. The ACRI lexicon include the ultrasound description for masses, the shape, oval or round, the margins, circumscribed or not circumscribed, microlobulate or spiculate, the echo pattern, anechoic, hyperechoic, hypoechoic, isoechoic, the orientation, parallel, wider than tall, or not parallel, taller than wide, and the posterior features with the enhancement or shadowing post. The ultrasound features regarding to the composition is cystic nodule, spongiform nodule, mixed solid cystic nodule, or almost solid cystic nodule. The echogenicity is anechoic nodule or transonic, the hyperechoic nodule, the hypoechoic nodule, or the very hypoechoic nodule. Regarding the shape, can be more wider than tall or more taller than wide, and the size can be measurement in the anteroposterior and transversal diameters. The margins can be smooth or ill-defined or lobulate, irregular, or extra thyroid extension. And if are the presence of microcalcification, the peripheral calcification, the punctat echogenic foci, the comet tail artifacts, and the non-calcification. The eggshell calcification or macrocalcification on the transversal section with the shadowing, posterior shadowing, and also the microcalcification in the transversal with the hard stiffness in elastography and the eggshell in the longitudinal section, the vascularization of the nodule and the parenchyma. To differentiate probably benign from probably malign thyroid nodules are based on 8 parameters: internal consistency, echogenicity, margins, surrounding halo, thin, thick, kimploplet or no halo, calcification, vascularization, presence or absence of lymph nodes, and tumor stiffness. The ultrasound pattern of malignancy are a solid nodule with hypoechogenic or marked hypoechogenic, with nodule shape frequently more taller than wide, the irregular margins, lobulate, extrathyroidal extension and absence of halo, microcalcification with the punctat echogenic foci with the high positive predictive value, peri- and intranodal vascularization, the presence of cervical adenopathy and heart stiffness. Ultrasound aspects of the benignity of the malignancy of the thyroid tumors in the right lobe with the benign nodule pattern and in the left lobe with the malignant pattern. A round hypoechogenic nodule, homogen with the higher vascularization of the parenchyma in the left lobe and the hypervascularization in the left lobe and the hard stiffness of the nodule in the score 4 of Rego and the vascularization of the nodule peripheral, the type 2 vascularization. Also another nodule in the right lobe with the thin halo is an isoechogen nodule with the round shape and peripheral vascularization in the power doppler with the Rego 2 in elastography. The normal appearance of lymph node with the hilum with the efferent vessel and with the artery with a palisadic distribution in the cortical zone. And also the efferent and afferent. The cervical ultrasounds for the lymph node levels in the below the chin is the one station, in the sternocleidomastoidian muscle in superior part is the second level, in the middle is the third level, and in the inferior is the fourth level, and retro sternocleidomastoidian is the fifth level, and medial for the sternocleidomastoidian is the sixth level of the lymphonodes level. In benign adenopathy, the lymph node is large, oval, hypoechogenic, with a hyperechogenic center, well contoured with a single dilatate vascular pole. In malignant adenopathy, in the neoplastic invasion, the lymph node has a round shape, is homogeneous or hypoechogenous in the lymphome, or neo-homogeneous, unhomogeneous, hyperechogenous in metastasis, with well vascularized, with multiple muscular poles like a spider. This is the malign cervical node, lymph nodes, and the lymph nodes in the lymphoma with aspects of spider. This is benign lymphadenopathy with the one vascular pole. And the round shape of the lymphadenopathy with the multiple vascular pole and measurement. We use in our ultrasound software the ACR thyroid scores. The ACR thyroid is a score of category 1 to 5 and can predict the necessity of the biopsy. This is the spectrum of the thyroid nodules in categorization according to the thyroid ACR. The high suspicion aspects, more taller than white, irregular or microlobulate merges, a microcalcification marked hypoechogenicity, is then the thyroid 4B and thyroid 5. The second classification including in our smart software was the euthyroid after RAS. Euthyroid split the thyroid nodule in a nodule with a high suspicion and the nodule with no features of high suspicion, euthyroid 2, 3 and 4. The euthyroid classification is starting with the normal thyroid with no nodules and non-risk to the euthyroid 5 with high risk and 80% risk of malignancy. The euthyroid classification image of the normal to the malignant pattern. The ACR versus euthyroid follow-up. In the thyroid 1, in the ACR, no follow-up. In the thyroid 2, no follow-up. And the thyroid 3 to 5, we have the follow-up. And the, regarding to the dimension of the nodule. And the comparison between the ACR thyroid and euthyroid classification. The third thyroid algorithm by RAS modified, used in the smart thyroid software, is the thyroid classification in 6 scores. And from 1 to 3 is the normal aspect and the probable benign lesions. And to 4 to 6 is the low suspicion, medium suspicion, and high suspicion with 1 suspicion feature to 5 suspicion features in the ultrasonography. Like unhomogeneous solid nodule with marked hypoechogenic, with microlobulation or irregular margins or extrathyroidal extension, with presence of macrocalcification, more taller than white. And we introduce the vascularization in the classification, the type 3 of nodule vascularization with internal and peripheral vasculature in the thyroid 4C, 5 and 6. It's very important feature. And the last score we use in the smart ultrasound software is the ultrasound score of malignancy. When the score is below 10 points, that supports the benign etiology, and when the score is over 20 points, supports the malignancy. The sensitivity of this score is the 90%, the specificity 95%, and the accuracy is 93%. And include 1 to 3 points of every ultrasound feature obtained to ultrasonography, multiparametric ultrasonography. This score is the risk stratification of the pathology with the ultrasound pattern of the thyroid nodules with the estimated risk of malignancy with the thyroid biological investigation, relative indication, and all of the largest size of the thyroid nodule make some recommendation related to the finding the respiration biopsy and for the Bethesda exam. All these scores and classification make certain risk classification for malignancy and determine the appropriate time for biopsy. After the biopsy with Bethesda result at the high score risk, we have established by software the patient's follow-up behavior. Dynamic evaluation of focal lesion in 6 months, the growth of nodule in dynamic more than 20%, changing the risk category and follow-up the postoperative relapse, assessment of the dynamic. The fine needle aspiration decision-making depends on the size of the nodule. On the transversal section, a more taller than wide nodule, hypoechogenic with higher vascularity in an entire nodule in the power Doppler and in the duplex Doppler. The presence of the nodule is unhomogeneous, marked hypoechogenic and with necrosis, with intense vascularization in the center and the peripheral type 3 of nodule, in the power and in the Doppler duplex, with the hard stiffness in the elastography in the strain ratio below 1.7. In the longitudinal section of this nodule, the presence of the vascularization internal and peripheral, in the power Doppler, in the duplex Doppler, and presence of a cyst or a necrosis, central necrosis, with the hard in the elastography. Another nodule, hypoechogenic unhomogeneous nodule, more taller than wide with microcalcification, and the presence of microcalcification and extracapsular extension, more taller than wide, unhomogeneous, the presence of microcalcification and vascularization in the entire nodule in the duplex and the power Doppler, higher vascularization with the hard stiffness in the elastography of the nodule, and the strain ratio is over 2.5. The strain ratio is 3.9. Another multinodular goiter, vascularization internal and peripheral, type 3 of vascularization with calcification, central calcification with shadowing. And another nodule, hypoechoic nodule with microcalcification and necrosis with intense vascularization or higher vascularization in the central and peripheral. Another image with the hypoechogenic, more taller than wide nodule with extracapsular extension with peripheral vascularization and unhomogeneous, and the type 4 of Rego in the elastography with the strain ratio 2.6. And another image of the nodule, a hypoechogenic nodule with soft stiffness, and in the right lobe, and in the left lobe, the hypoechogenic nodule with extracapsular extension with the peripheral parathyroid pathology, although the normal parathyroid gland is not commonly observed on ultrasound. Parathyroid lesions such as hyperplasia, adenoma, or cyst may be seen near the posterior of inferior thyroid lobe. Usually the parathyroid adenoma appears as well circumscribed round or oval hypoechoic nodule. Not infrequently, but parathyroid adenoma may develop the cystic degeneration and may contain the calcification, and if this type of pathology is also present, it may lead to the misdiagnosis. The laboratory investigation required is the serum parathormone and the parathyroid adenoma. Parathyroid adenoma, and the cyst. The last recommendation of the elastography guidelines is the ultrasound elastography of the thyroid should be used a part of a nodule characterization, particularly with use of the semi-quantitative methods, is the level A of evidence. The ultrasound longitudinal wave propagation in human tissue with minimal deformation caused by the applying an external mechanical force inducing a particle oscillation who will be sent in the nearby from one tissue element to another, and tissue oscillation occurs along the direction of longitudinal wave propagation in the strain elastography. In the strain elastography, the principle of this technique is that an elastic medium is compressed with a constant axial oriented pressure, producing deformation into the tissue. Different tissue have different stiffness and their deformation will be different. This technique is defined also a quasi-static elastography and it is qualitative technique. Initial hand compression was used for the tissue deformation, but in the newly developed system, heart beating and are used to stress the tissue. Elasticity is displayed using a color code image superimposed on the B-mode image in red and green softer tissue and in blue stiffer tissue. The new Hitachi system, High Vision, display a histogram and 11 parameters which are used to calculate stiffness. Strain elastography versus B-real-time shear-wave elastography with the longitudinal and trans. Strain elastography score by Rego from 1 to 5 indicate no elasticity in the 5 score and presence of elasticity in the whole nodule in the score. Rego classification score 1, score 2 with the few hard stiffness in the entire nodule. Score 3 with the hard stiffness in the central more than 50% of the nodule. Score 4 with the hard stiffness in entire nodule and score 5 with the hard stiffness surrounding the nodule. Hard stiffness nodule in the score 4. After Rego classification, you can splice the probably benign nodule in the score 1 and 2 and suspicion score with the Rego 4 and 5. An homogeneous isoechogenic nodule with peripheral vascularization in the power and the Doppler and an undefined margins of this nodule with the thin halo and the peripheral vascularization of the nodule and the power Doppler vascularization peripheral and the measurement of the ease, the vascularization, the higher vascularization in the left lobe and the presence of the nodule in the longitudinal section with the craniocaudal dimension and vascularization in this, but with very hard stiffness in the 4 score of after elastography. Another image with the nodule with the extracapsular extension with the present of microcalcification and the present of necrosis and also with an internal and peripheral to the entire nodule of the vascularization, the present of microcalcification and the vascularization power Doppler with the hard stiffness and strain ratio over 2.5. And the hard stiffness of the nodule and the Rego 5 score and another nodule present in the left lobe and vascularization of the nodule and presence of macrocalcification in the central part of the nodule and the present of the strain ratio. In attempt to perform a standardized an objective assessment of stiffness, a numerical parameter, the strain ratio, was introduced. The strain ratio report is a semi-quantitative analysis comparing rigidity of elasticity on two different areas within the same image. Two regions of interest are manually applied on the screen, one on the target lesion tract and the second on the normal thyroid reference, which allow to calculate their real-time ratio with the immediate strain ratio analysis automatically by ultrasound. The presence of a nodule with the higher vascularization in entire nodule in center and the peripheral with the hard stiffness in the Rego 4 score. The presence of the vascularization peripheral of the nodule. In the another image with the cyst and the giant cyst of the left lobe of thyroid and into the cyst it's presents an formation a nodule with the and can be degenerescence of the cyst. And we have the in the smart software we use a lot of algorithms for the established defined aspiration biopsy, and also the algorithm for the single thyroid nodule and presence of a nodule with peripheral vascularization, the well delimited with a thin halo. Results. Each patient was examined after the ultrasound protocol designed by us. The statistical analysis was performed with MedCalc program. We have made the diagnostic algorithm software correlated with results from finding the aspiration biopsy for performing the thyroid ultrasound screening by the family physician. We made an initial some descriptive statistics. We analyzed the data of thyroid screening, sensitivity, specificity, and accuracy. And we make the comparative statistical analysis evaluating different diagnosis ultrasound techniques that we use in the study for establishment of the differential diagnosis of malignant versus benign thyroid tumors. Finally, we use the comparative statistical analysis for the three groups of score by ultrasound methods, rock curve analysis, and analog. Results, we find 861 cases with diffuse thyroid disorders, thyroiditis, acute, subacute, and chronic, thyroid malformation, the thyroid lobe agenesis, hypoplasia, congenital myxedema, and goiter. We find 416 patients with simple or mixed cyst or colloid nodule, and 280 patients with the solid tumors, benign 228 and malign 52 patients. 230 were benign tumors with hyperplastic nodule, follicular adenoma, Hashimoto thyroid nodules, subacute thyroiditis nodule, and remaining 50 malignant lesions with the papillary carcinoma, the most commonly 80%, the medullary carcinoma 7%, the follicular carcinoma 11%, the anaplastic thyroid cancer, and the Hartel cell carcinoma less than 1%. The incidence of the malignant tumor was 1.13% in our thyroid screening. The sensitivity of the ultrasound screening was 96%, with specificity 96%, and the accuracy of method 96%. The prevalence of thyroid pathology was 38%. Rock curve statistical analysis confirmed a higher level of diagnostic accuracy of the ultrasound scoring system. And the second place was the strain elastography compared with the Doppler triplex ultrasound. The ANOVA analysis is the significant statistical method used and was the ultrasound scoring system. The THYROSCREEN screening has a very good sensitivity, about 96%, a very good specificity and very good accuracy, about 96%. The number of patient diagnosis and the oncology screening was distributed in 7% with the malignant solid tumors, 59% of the cystic tumors, and 34% of benign solid tumors. And we have the distribution of age in our. This is a graphic with distribution of all patients find positive to the ultrasound screening. With the malignant focal lesion, 7%. With the benign focal lesion in 41% and with diffuse thyroid disorders in 51% with the all kind of pathology. The distribution of all cases in the RAGO classification, in the Thyros classification, and in the ultrasound malignancy score is with the similarity. The THYROSCREEN results cases distribution related to the thyroids after RAS classification. The distribution of all cases after the malignancy ultrasound score. The use of several ultrasound techniques and the use of the ultrasound score that contains both malignancy marker in the grayscale and malignancy elements of the vascularization and tissue stiffness greatly increased the accuracy of this screening, as shown by the two comparative statistical analyses, ANOVA one-way and area under curve graphics. The presence of the hypoechogenic unhomogeneous nodule with the higher vascular peripheral vascularization and with the heart stiffness. An unhomogeneous hypoechogen nodule with extracapsular extension with the heart stiffness and strain ratio over 2.5. An hypoechogenic nodule with the well-defined with the soft stiffness in the RIGO 2 and to peripheral vascularization type 2. And hypoechogen nodule, undefined, delimited, and with the peripheral vascularization and with the heart stiffness present. And chronic thyroiditis, Hashimoto, with higher parenchymal vascularization and with the heart stiffness. Presence of the isoecogen unhomogeneous nodule with the vascularization to the periphery, type 2 vascularization, and with the heart stiffness in elastography. Chronic thyroiditis with the hypervascularization and entire parenchyma and with the heart stiffness. Post-surgical evaluation of the thyroid. Transversal section with the hypoplasic lobe, left lobe, the hypoplasy of left lobe, and the hypervascularization parenchyma of the right lobe, and hypervascularization and power Doppler, and the dimension and the presence of the nodule in the right lobe, and undefined nodule, isoecogen, unhomogeneous. Another mixed cystic solid nodule with the vascularization in the peripheral with the heart stiffness in elastography, and the second nodule in the left lobe. And aspects of Hashimoto thyroiditis nodules with the soft stiffness and intratumoral necrosis in the heart stiffness. In conclusion, the ultrasonography proves to be a very efficient method with the high value in the thyroid screening with a very good accuracy for the early detection of diffuse disease and tumors of thyroid in asymptomatic stage. The Doppler ultrasound has a high value in thyroid screening for early detection of tumors and for diagnosis of angiogenesis with development of vascular network. The Thyro-screen over 3 requires special attention and future investigation. The strain elastography brings us important details in the differential diagnosis benign versus malignant, so thyroid tumors with heart stiffness classified in 4 or 5 after RIGO scores and with strain ratio over 3 are predominantly malignant. The performance Doppler ultrasound together with the strain elastography have the best sensitivity and specificity in the differential benign versus malignant of the thyroid tumors in the primary care. Take-home messages: finding the ultrasound scan of the markers for the thyroid malignancy, like an unhomogeneous solid tumor with a marked hypoechogenicity, with irregular margins, spiculite or lobular contour, the presence of microcalcification with oval shape more taller than wide, with the central and peripheral tumor hypervascularization, type 3 vasculature, and the presence of cervical lymph nodes. And if there is a suspicion of malignancy, then the finding the aspiration biopsy and the cytological test is required as a gold standard diagnostic method. The shear-wave elastography will bring additional elements in the future, but for the time being, we believe that in primary care it will be useful to use only the strain elastography as a means of the electronic palpation of the tumor by the future family doctors. In the shear-wave elastography, the cut-off value of each elasticity index in the index for predicting malignancy was 85.2 kilopascal. And finally, we EUVEKUS invites you to attend to the Eurosound Focus School Vienna, Austria, with the conference entitled The Point of Care Ultrasonography in Primary Healthcare and Ambulatory Healthcare, Update and Perspective, on 10 to 11 September 2021. Thank you very much. Join the Focus Revolution.